Hey, everybody. Okay, I'm gonna do today's stretching routine. I had to take a break yesterday. I woke up tired. I wanted to eat all day long. I did not want to exercise. I didn't want to do anything. And so I had to tell myself that it was okay to take a break for the day because I do go, go, go. And right now, honestly, I don't want to be out here doing this right now either. But I know that I'm the type person that when I stop doing something, I stop doing it for a week or I stop doing it for a month. And I'm finding exercising, even if just stretching and other things, I'm finding it very valuable. And I'm also quite aware of the fact that as we age, we need to be able to move around. We need to have functional strength. We need to be able to do laundry and make the beds and do all those types of things. And just using your body, even with static holds, you're gonna get a lot of great strength and flexibility and just have more mobility. So I'm gonna do my stretching routine today. And I didn't even wanna go upstairs and change clothes. I just finished doing the fast track for tonight and I said, if I go upstairs, I'm not gonna come back down. So I'm gonna get my stretching in. I'm gonna go upstairs, make myself a little calm drink, get a shower, go to bed. So feel free to join me. These exercise routines are done in a way that you could just join along with me, all right? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to stretch my neck. And if you hop on, please say hello. I know you might not want to hang out with me and do the whole exercise, but say hi. I'll see it in a minute. You could also save this video and do it later. You can kind of archive it and do it later. I count till 30 in my head, but I actually count to 45 because I count fast. If I wanted to do two things, I'm wondering if I can do two things. I think this right here will count for a minute. I can have my head over like that for a minute and get a stretch on here too with my arms. I'm gonna try that. Actually, I have to remind myself not to count. I'm so used to counting. This thing beeps for me. I also realized that I am standing with my bottom out and my stomach out, all that. So I have tucked my bottom in and I have pulled my stomach in. Trying to get my core tight. That was 60 seconds on that side. Feel free to say hello if you hop on. You don't have to hang out with me if you're not ready to exercise, but I'd love to see you say hello. That was 1 minute on both sides. You know, I normally can feel that stretch. I think I actually might hold this stretch a little bit better without this because I'm more focused on holding that out than getting my stretch, so I'm not sure I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and do, turn it. I don't know about you, but I find myself going back to that natural slouch, and I have to work to actually stand up straight. Okay, so now I'm going to do my biceps. I'm actually going to use this to get a better stretch on it. So I'm pulling and holding this back. Okay, I'm gonna try something else. I'm gonna push out. See if I work. See, I did a little bit different move. If you don't have a stretch a minute, which is that tool right there, you can just take your arms and do this. Okay, and hold that, and that'll work the biceps. But I hold it with a stretch a minute to count my time. Okay, so now I'm gonna do triceps. Now triceps, if you do not have the stretch a minute, you can just pull it back and hold it just like that, okay? No problem. But I'm gonna use the stretch a minute to count my time. on that one, I actually pulled down just a little bit more so I could feel the stretch in my tricep a little bit better. Because when I do this, I actually can push it back kind of far, and I didn't feel like I was getting the same pull. But what I did was I just kind of tucked that one handle down just a little bit more, and I got a better stretch out of it. So that was triceps. Now I'm going to do wrist flexors, and I'm going to do wrist flexors both up and down. If you're ever doing anything that's uncomfortable, reposition. Also, when you're doing this, if I'm just doing this, I'm not feeling any stretch in here. I actually have to have my arm pretty straight and pull down on that to get this stretch right here. So you can't just do it like this. You gotta pull it out. But not so hard that you hurt it. But I do at least feel it. Honestly, just holding your arms up like that is going to give you a little bit of strength too. Okay, so now I'm going to do shoulders. I'm gonna do the trapezius. I do the trapezius with this. Thirty on the trapezius. We'll do the obliques. That's these muscles here. Sometimes I just like to do this, just like reach, just reach up, and you're just getting some good movement and stretching. Keep your body flexible. The chiropractor says that I should open up my chest more because I tend to just kind of curl in like that. So I'm going to use these again, but I'm going to hold them a different way. I'm going to hold them out like this. That's different than I was holding before. I'm even going to bend over a little, see if I can get a better stretch. I get tired of standing there and one. Woo! See, this thing, this stretch a minute holds you accountable. I'm already wondering how to get out of this. Oh, hello. My husband's looking at me over the fence. Stretch a minute? No.
On camera.
Uh-huh. Okay. So now I'm going to get that hip flexor muscle. I'm just stepping forward and I'm pushing my pelvic area forward, but I'm specifically stretching this right here. pull out of this real slow because this is a really important muscle and I don't want to do anything to kink it up. Okay, so I've done the same move. I'm just pushing forward right here. Y'all see the lightning bugs? Okay. Quadricep. You can do that in a chair as well and laying down. I just like to practice my balance. Feel free to say hello. Okay, so anytime you do your quads, you always do your hamstrings. If you do the front side of one muscle, you do the back side of it. If you do the left side, you do the right side, and so forth. I'm actually going to use a stretch a minute to do my hamstrings today. You can do this without a stretch a minute, but the stretch a minute holds you accountable because it counts for you. The stretch a minute is $49.95 at myshabolic.com/shop. The reason my leg is shaking is because my hamstring is tight. There's a beetle. If it gets in my hair, I'm gonna scream. With this beeping every 10 seconds, it's a good positive feedback as well as holding you accountable for holding the stretch as long as it should be held. Now, if you're just starting, you can do smaller increments, but you want to build up, and of course, consistency is important. There's a bat that's flying over me. There's another one. So I got lightning bugs, beetles, and bats. Okay, I actually haven't been doing these lately because I haven't had time, but I'm going to do these lumbar extensions. I probably can do this with a stretch minute too. Yeah. But what I'm doing right here is I'm pulling this leg in, and really I'm stretching my lower back. I'm going to do the internal rotator. I was kind of repositioning then because it was hurting my knee a little bit. Doing that one as long because I haven't done much of it and it was hurting a little bit. Okay, so now I'm going to do groin. You remember though when they used to tell you to bounce and do stuff? That is not suggested. Just hold it. Okay, so that was groin. And this one is so important because this right here, this is tight.
Oh, it's tight. And I don't know if that's the hamstring or not, because it's more right here. It's called adductors. Also stretching my lower back too. It feels good. Last but not least, sorry it's getting dark. Y'all can watch the lightning bugs behind me. It's getting dark. We're gonna go in, but just to let you know, I did not want to come out here and do this, but I made myself do it, and now that I've done it, I feel much better, kind of like most things. All right, see y'all tomorrow.